The question is, why is it that Yetzer Hara is stronger than the Yetzer HaTov? It's a good question, right? Why Yetzer Hara, Kadosh Baruch Hu created it stronger than Yetzer HaTov? It says in the Mishnah, Ben Azai Omer, Heve Ratz Lemitzvah Kala Kevachamura, Uvorech Min Ha'avera. You should run and chase after the mitzvot and run away from the averot. So, in the Sefer of Avolbe, he writes that very question. He says that it's not fair. There's no bechira equal bechira over here. Why is that? Because the mitzvah itself seems like it's running away from you and you have to chase it. Everatz, le mitzvah kala, kavachamura. Everatz le mitzvah, you have to run after the mitzvah. It's running away from you. And by avera, what happens by avera? Borech min avera. It's chasing you. And you have to run away. Not fair. HaKadosh Baruch Hu should have created this equal. Mitzvot, the same way as averot. Which means mitzvah here, avera here. Either they're both running after you, or both running away from you, and you have to run after both of them, or both of them standing still, and you choose between the two. Why is it that avera is always running after you? Mitzvah runs away from you. So listen to this fascinating answer. It says, when we're dealing with mitzvot and averot, you need to know, if both of them was the same level, they both were either running after you, standing still, or chasing, or running away from you, of course, any person in the world would be running after the mitzvah and not go after the averah. Who would want to go after the averah? If it's equal, if you have the same pool to do the mitzvah as the avera, of course you'll do the mitzvah. Who wants to do avera? The only time you'll do avera is if it's chasing after you and you're running away. But in a certain, while you're running away, you see the avera, you look back and it's so delicious, it's so good, and you're so tired already from running away. Yeah, it's really so. A person could run away from avera 1 day, 2 days, 3 days. He could be mitgaber ke'ari, but on the fourth day, he's already, you know, it's been after him for so long. So he falls and he sins. That's the way avera works. If mitzvah would be standing still, of course a person would grab the mitzvah. The only time you don't grab the mitzvah if it's running away from you. So since it's running away from you, you have to chase it. That's hard. That's the only time a person would have a bechira. In order to make, in other words, the answer is like this. In order to make the bechira equal, you have to have that the avera runs after you, because if he wouldn't run after you, you wouldn't do it. It's running after you. And the only time you would maybe not do the mitzvah, if it's running away from you. If it's here, of course you'll do the mitzvah. If it's hand, it's close to you and you can do it, you'll do the mitzvah for sure. It's running away from you. Then you have bechira. Should I do it? Should I not do it? I have to run after it. It's hard. The avera, if it's here and it's not running away from you, of course you stay away. Stay away. Chek min shachen ra. Stay away from something bad, of course. But if it's running after you, that's when the bechira happens. That is when you have the choice between doing something good falling in the avera or not falling in avera. And that's why HaKadosh Baruch Hu created that avera should be stronger than the mitzvah, or the more correct, the Yetzer Hara will be stronger than the Yetzer HaTov. Because otherwise, every person in the world would go with the Yetzer HaTov and do the mitzvah and not do the avera, and there wouldn't be an equal bechira. Next question.